watching from afar, she mimicked him, perfecting her own secret dance. Wishing those fleeting moments of light would stretch out to last forever.
No, it's a trick. It's an illusion. It's not real. But you freaking want it's real. You want to believe it's real, but it's a trick. You're deluded.
Where are you going?
Where is she going? What is she following? You can't even fight. It's just deception.
How does he so effortlessly court the world and bliss? If only she could do the same. See the world through eyes anew. And dance with it. Just like he does.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I don't leave home much.
Oh, Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You... learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillian. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who is supposed to reassure you. Make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are.
You killed him.
But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, and don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No!
And all your suffering will have been for nothing!
Shut up!
You want to believe it.
Is he there?
It's not real.
Is he there?
You're alone in these mountains.
Is that Delia?
Nothing lives here.
You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
Answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the Tree of Death will take you to new lands, where you will face the trials.
Forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrfing.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong. Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
For the trials, like when we first met, remember?
There he is.
There he is.
Dillian,
there he is.
Finally.
You found him.
What's wrong? What happened? Can you hear me?
How did you let him go?
Just wait there. I'll find you.
Find him, get him back.
He was just there. How could you lose him? How could she lose him?
How could she? Find him.
Dillian's calling to you. Can
you
hear
him? Where is he?
He sounds like he's getting further away.
Have you lost him?
You're going the wrong way.
Are you lost and have you lost him?
Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving.
I can save you.
It's too scary.
I can hear him.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Think. Focus. Use your mind.
Where's he gone? He's disappeared.
Look.
You let him slip through your fingers once again.
You don't recognize him.
Don't doubt yourself. You'll never find it.
She doesn't recognize him.
Yes, you do. You know where you are.
She doesn't.
Listen for his voice. Listen.
Dillian, where
listen
are you?
Listen for his voice.
Look the same.
Looks the same.
Something.
Look for clues.
What is it?
What's different?
There's a clue.
Look. Light the torch.
Light it.
Look for the torch.
Light it.
Have you
seen
him? It's not him.
We told you. We told you it was a trick.
doesn't sound like Dillion anymore.
What's happening? It's not him, it can't be.
What's that sound? The voice is changing.
What? That's not Dillion.
Within the burial mound, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword. She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning. You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead. Like I said, she reminds me of you.
Where are we?
She has no idea.
We're going round in circles.
You have fallen in.
You think that sound is Dillion's voice? It's a trap.
You walked right into their hands.
They have you right where they want you.
How could you?
You think that voice is Dillion's?
It's not.
It's beckoning you to.
Do when the torch runs out.
Wander around until it gets dark.
How
and then will you dare?
Will you save yourself? There's nothing
will come to claim you again.
Nothing you can do. Nothing.
It's not Dillion. Wants me to face my fears. Father. I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief, sir.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you, they will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come, Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
It's broken.
There's no way you can fix it.
What do you do now, sir?
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts.
Through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe.
Dillian.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go.
Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe? I did not ask the mistletoe, Baldur's mother confesses. I thought it was too young. Oh dear.
Do you remember him whispering in your ear? He's the reason she keeps fighting. Do you remember the way he stroked your hair? Do you remember the way he felt?
You can't go up
you
there.
You can't go up there.
Not in this world.
Strangled.
Dark. saw who she could be.
He saw who she really was.
He saw the warrior within. Do you remember meeting him beneath the tree?
Senua, you've got it.
Why isn't he here?
He's gone.
He's in the dark world.
He's gone to the dark world.
You're in the wrong world.
Without you, the way he touched you.
Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing she loves.
She destroys the thing she loves.
She thought she had light within her when she left.
She is pure darkness.
He was the only one she could trust.
Could she trust him? Dillian saved you from them. Do you even remember?
His love is guiding you.
Look what happens to me.
Thank you.
led you astray.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taken part. Hoth says, I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon. Loki replies, here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands. And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Baldur. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Baldur is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
Dillion doesn't know who killed him, but we do.
She really was.
He saw the warrior within. Things you love. You have no chance for love now.
Nobody will love you again.
Ever. Ever again.
Are you
precious to you.
to your father when you were young. Look what happens to the things you love.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon. Loki replies, here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands. And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Baldur. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Baldur is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
Cannot be undone.
Was it worth it?
Dillion doesn't know who killed him, but we do. Do you know? Was it worth it?
You're still alive and Dillion's dead.
He doesn't deserve to be dead. How does that make you feel?
He was the only one she could trust.
Could she trust him? he's the reason she's alive at all.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The god.
You've killed him with your love because he believed in you.
You are guilty.
Was it worth it?
You have no chance for love now.
Nobody will love you again.
Ever. Ever again.
You kill. Dillion.
Poor Dillion. He didn't know he was kind. He believed you. Dillion saved her.
You owe your life to Dillion.
You owe everything to him. Does it feel warm? Do you feel safe?
Dillion loves you.
Thank you. must touch him. He led you astray.
You should have listened to your father when you had the chance.
Why didn't you listen to him?
This love has tortured you, and it tortures me. She thought she had light within her. She is pure darkness.
You astray.
You should have listened to your father when you had the chance.
Why didn't you listen to him?
This love has tortured you, and it tortures me.
You have no chance. Do you know? Was it worth it?
You're still alive and Dillian's dead. He doesn't deserve to be dead.
How does that make you feel?
Years have passed since she left her father. Trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught.